Welcome to our online class. Look at these pictures. What do these pictures represent? These pictures represent our surroundings. Our surroundings consist of living things and non-living things. Everything in our surrounding is made up of matter. Today we are going to discuss about matter in our surroundings. What are we going to learn? Matter definition, physical nature of matter, characteristic particles of matter, states of matter, change of states of matter, evaporation and factors affecting evaporation. Matter. Do you know what is meant by matter? Anything which occupies space and has mass is called matter. Space. Anything which occupies space and has mass. What is mass? Mass is the amount of matter in an object. SI unit of mass is kilogram. Weight is different, mass is different. Weight is related to the gravitational force. Weight is the measure of how much gravity acts on an object. So, weight is the measure of how much gravity acts on an object. Examples of matter. Air we breathe, food we eat, stone, cloud, stars, a particle of sand, a drop of water, plant and animal. These are the examples of matter. These are the things, are examples of matter. The only conditions for something to be matter are that it should have mass and occupy space. Thing without matter. There are certain things are not considered as matter. Emotion, energy, light energy, information, music and this one is energy. And things such as friendship, smell, taste, etc. are not considered as matter because they do not occupy space and have mass. Classification of matter. Early Indian philosophers classified matter in the form of five basic elements. Panch Tattva. Panch means five. Tattva. So the basic element. It is a Sanskrit word. What are the five basic elements? Air, water, fire, sky, and earth. Air, fire, water, sky, and earth. Our universe is made up of these five basic elements. Air, fire, water, air and sky. Modern day scientists have evolved two types of classification based on physical properties. What are physical properties? The characteristic of matter which can be observed or measured without changing the chemical composition. So based on physical properties, matter can be classified into five types: solid, liquid, gas, plasma, and most ancient condensate. So five states are there. Out of these five states, three states are most common: solid state, liquid state, and gaseous state are most common states. Now, solid state. Solids are rigid, they have fixed shape, and fixed volume. So solids are rigid, they have fixed shape, and they have fixed volume. Example: table, chair, pen, pencil, etc. Solid cannot be compressed. Next state, liquid. Liquid, they are not rigid, they don't have fixed shape, they have fixed volume, they cannot be compressed. Next one, gas. Gaseous state, they are not rigid, they don't have fixed shape, they don't have fixed volume, they can be compressed. So examples of solid: table, chair, pen, pencil. Examples of liquid: milk, water, oil, etc. And gaseous state: oxygen, carbon dioxide, water, vapor. This is the new state, fourth state, plasma. Who discovered the state? Plasma state was identified by William Crookes in the year 1879. William Crookes, 1879. This is the state of plasma. Plasma state example. Aurora, solar wind, nuclear fireball, and lightning are examples of plasma state. So who discovered, identified plasma state? William Crookes. Now we are going to discuss about plasma. Plasma state consists of excited particles, super excited and energetic particles. See, fluorescent bulb, neon sign bulb consists of plasma. Fluorescent bulb has helium gas. Inside the bulb, helium gas is present. Neon sign bulb consists of neon gas. When electricity is passed through the gas, it gets ionized and gets charged. It creates plasma and start glowing up inside the bulb. Sun and stars glow because of the presence of plasma in them. So electricity, when electricity is passed through the gas which is inside the bulb, it gets ionized, ionized particles are formed and get charged and it creates plasma. So the ionization takes place. sun and the stars glow because of the plasma. Bose-Einstein condensate. Bose-Einstein condensate was formed by with the theory of S.N. Bose and Albert Einstein, which is called as BEC, Bose-Einstein condensate. This is the fifth state of the matter. This is a picture of Bose-Einstein condensate. Bose-Einstein condensate. BEC. It is formed by cooling a gas. This cooling is important. So, how is it formed? It is formed by cooling a gas of extremely low density. Density should be low. So extremely low density, about 100,000 the density of the normal air to super low temperatures. We get Bose-Einstein condensate. So Bose-Einstein condensate is formed by cooling a gas of extremely low density, about 100,000 the density of normal air to super low temperature. Matter can be classified into elements, compounds and mixture based on chemical nature. Based on chemical nature. What are elements? Elements are made up of same kind of atoms. Example, solid state we can give gold, silver. Liquid state, bromine. Gaseous state, oxygen, hydrogen. Now, second one, compound. What is compound? Two or more elements combined in a particular ratio, definite ratio, compounds are formed. Example, H2O O. What are the elements present in it? Hydrogen and oxygen. Look at this. Two parts of hydrogen combine one part of oxygen. We'll get water. Same way we can explain carbon dioxide. Another example, carbon dioxide, CO2. It is the compound. It consists of carbon and oxygen. Two elements are there. One part of carbon and two parts of oxygen. Combine and give carbon dioxide. Mixtures. Elements and compounds just mix together and form mixture. Example, iron and soil. And can be separated easily by using a magnet. Physical nature of matter. Matter is made up of particles. Particles of matter are so tiny. Matter is made up of particles. This is explained with the help of an activity. Take a beaker, fill it with water. Add salt or sugar. Dissolve it. Salt or sugar disappears. Why they disappear? Because salt is made up of particles of salt. Water is made up of particles of water. So, particles of water have space in between them. So, sugar particles occupy that space and completely disappear. So, matter is made up of particles. Particles of matter are so tiny. We have learned what is matter, classification of matter, and physical nature of matter. Next class will discuss about properties of matter. Thank you.